In these problems, we want to identify the decimal plotted on the number line. So notice we have a value here plotted between 0 and 1. And I think it's probably going to be easier if we actually write this as a fraction first, and then write the fraction as a decimal. So from 0 to 1, this is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4 pieces, which means each of these would be 1/4. So this would be 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, and 4/4, or 1. So the number plotted is 3/4. Now you may recognize the decimal for 3/4, but let's just say that we don't. If we can write an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 10 or 100 or 1,000, it's going to make it much easier to write the decimal for 3/4. And since 4 times 25 is equal to 100, if we multiply the denominator by 25 and the numerator by 25, we'll have an equivalent fraction. So this is equivalent to 75/100. So if we know our place values, we can rewrite this as a decimal as 0.75. This would be 75/100. Let's try another one. Notice here we have a number somewhere between 6 and 7. And notice that between 6 and 7 we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 equal parts. So this would be 6 1/5, 6 2/5, 6 3/5, 6 4/5, and then we're finally at 7. And maybe I should include the 6's here just to be more accurate. But now our goal is to rewrite 6 3/5 as a decimal. And for 3/5, we can write an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 10 rather than 100 like we did for the first example. We can multiply this by 2 and multiply this by 2. So this is equivalent to 6 6/10. Well, if we know our place values, 6 6/10 would be 6.6. So the value plotted on the number line, 6 3/5, written as a decimal, is 6.6. Let's go and take a look at one more example. Now on this last example, it's a little bit different because we have a decimal value plotted on the number line, and this decimal value is divided into equal parts. And there are 1, 2, 3, 4 equal parts between 0 and 0.2. So we could probably figure out that this value in the middle would have to be 0.1, and then the value that would be halfway between 0 and 0.1 would be 0.05. And if that's hard to determine, remember we could add an extra 0 here, and then it's easier to see that half of 0.10 would be 0.05. And so we may also want to add a 0 here to 0.2. So now we can just start counting by 5/100, or 0.5, to determine the missing value. Here we have 5/100, 10/100, this would be 15/100, written as 0.15, and then we have 20/100. So because the given value was already in decimal form, this approach was a little bit different.